The real breakthrough here is that we're building a true ovarian bioprosthesis, and the goal of this project is to be able to restore fertility and endocrine health to young cancer patients who have been sterilized by their cancer treatment. Right now, we're able to do that with young mice, and the goal ultimately is to provide this back to patients.
Teresa and I have both wanted to create an ovary bioprosthesis or some sort of implant. So we said we need something that we can mold and build for exactly this purpose. And Ramil Shah's lab was right next door.
You know, from the very beginning, with any collaboration, it's always great if it's built on mutual respect for each other's work.
Scaffolds, if you think about a scaffold for a building, they're setting that up and they're building something that will eventually support itself.
We have constructed these scaffolds out of gelatin, and gelatin is just broken down collagen. And collagen is the most abundant extracellular matrix in our body. It's what gives us structure. It's in our bones, in our skin, etc. And the great advantage of doing gelatin over collagen is that it's much easier to process, but it still has the same, what we call, bioactivity as collagen.
So these illustrate the different pore structures or architectures we can achieve with our different ink platforms, as well as the 3D printer. And these pores will house the different cell types, and we're really trying to investigate how the structure can influence cell behavior and viability. And it also can expand towards other soft organ and tissue engineering applications, because we have the ability to 3D print basically any architecture that we think will be optimal for different cell types.
This is an example of one of the scaffolds that Alex has 3D printed, made out of gelatin. Our skilled technician removed the ovary of the mouse, replaced it with our scaffolds, sutured those back up, and we mated some of those animals, and we were able to get live birth out of these scaffolds.
Our hope is that one day this ovarian bioprosthesis is really the ovary of the future.